Have you ever wondered how your favorite beer is made? Our journey to the heart of beer making starts with four fundamental ingredients: water, barley, hops, and yeast. Each of these natural ingredients plays a vital role in brewing that perfect pint. Now let's talk about water. It's not just any water, but carefully sourced water. It makes up about 95% of beer, shaping its character and taste. Different regions have water with different mineral compositions, and that's why a stout from Dublin tastes different from a lager brewed in Munich. Next up, we have barley. It's the soul of beer, providing the sugars needed for fermentation. Barley gives beer its color, underlying flavor, and the alcohol content we all know and love. But before barley can do its job, it needs to go through a process called malting. We'll delve deeper into that in the next scene. Then, we welcome hops to the stage. These little green cones are the spice of beer, offering bitterness to balance the sweetness of the malt. Hops also provide those delightful aromas and flavors, from citrusy and floral to piney and earthy. Last, but certainly not least, we introduce yeast. This mighty microorganism feasts on the sugars from malted barley, producing alcohol and carbon dioxide. The type of yeast and the conditions under which it ferments can significantly impact the beer's flavor and aroma profile. And there you have it, the quartet that makes our beloved brew. Each ingredient is a soloist, but when they play together, they create a symphony of flavors and aromas that we recognize as beer. So, you see, the magic of beer begins with these four simple ingredients. Their journey from field and stream to your glass is a fascinating one, filled with science, tradition, and a touch of art. We'll explore each step in this intricate dance in the scenes to come. Stay tuned. Now, the journey of beer making begins with malting. Picture this: a barley grain, soaked in water until it's ready to sprout or germinate, and then dried out to halt this process. This is the essential first step in brewing, known as malting. It sounds simple, but it's a delicate dance, a balance of moisture and heat. When the barley is soaked, it wakes up and starts to germinate. As it grows, it begins to produce enzymes that are crucial to the brewing process. These enzymes have one very important job: they convert the barley starches into fermentable sugars. Once this conversion is complete, the germinated barley is dried and crushed to create malt. This malt is the sweet golden heart of every beer, ready to give its sugars to the brew. And that's how barley is prepared for brewing, through the process of malting. With our malted barley ready, we move on to the mashing and boiling stages. The journey of brewing beer is a fascinating one, and it's in these stages that we begin to see the transformation of our humble ingredients into something truly special. Let's start with mashing. In this process, our malted barley is mixed with hot water. But why hot water, you may ask? Well, the heat activates enzymes in the malt, which then go to work on the starches present in the barley, breaking them down into fermentable sugars. This mixture, known as the mash, is then allowed to rest. As it does, the enzymes continue their work, further converting any remaining starches. After some time, we're left with a sweet, sugary liquid. This, dear listeners, is what we call wort. It's the base from which all beers are born. But before it can become the beer we all know and love, it must undergo a few more transformations. This brings us to the boiling stage. The wort is boiled, serving a dual purpose. Firstly, it sterilizes the liquid, ensuring that no unwanted bacteria or wild yeasts are present that could potentially ruin our beer. Secondly, it's during this boiling process that we add another key ingredient: hops. Hops are a crucial part of beer's identity. They contribute the bitterness that balances the sweetness of the malt, and they also provide the distinctive flavors and aromas that can make each beer unique. Depending on the beer style, hops can be added at different times during the boil, each time impacting the beer's flavor profile in a different way. The hops, having been added, infuse the boiling wort with their unique characteristics. As the boil concludes, the wort is now infused with the bitterness, flavor, and aroma of the hops, setting the stage for the next steps in the brewing process. So, boiling not only sterilizes our wort, but also introduces the unique flavors of the hops. And with that, we're ready to move on to the next stage in our beer's journey: fermentation. But that's a story for another time. After boiling comes the magical process of fermentation. Now, this is where the real magic happens. It's where our simple sugary wort starts its transformation into the delightful, complex beverage that is beer. First, let's introduce a new player into the game: yeast. This microscopic organism is a brewer's best friend. When yeast is added to the cooled wort, it immediately gets to work. It's a hungry little critter, and its favorite food is the sugars we've so carefully extracted from our malted barley. As the yeast consumes the sugars, it produces two very important byproducts. The first is alcohol, which, let's be honest, is a key reason we're all here. The second is carbon dioxide, which gives beer its signature fizz. This process is known as primary fermentation, and it typically takes anywhere from a few days to a week. But the yeast isn't done just yet. After the majority of the sugars have been consumed, the yeast enters a second stage known as secondary fermentation. This stage is slower and can last for several weeks. During secondary fermentation, the yeast continues to slowly consume any remaining sugars, further refining the beer's flavor. Secondary fermentation also allows for additional flavoring components to be added, if desired. This could be anything from fruit purees to spices, or even more hops for those who love a hop-heavy brew. The yeast continues to work its magic, integrating these flavors into the beer. Remember though, patience is key. The fermentation process can't be rushed. The yeast needs time to do its job properly, and the beer needs time to mature and develop its full range of flavors. It's this careful, patient process that helps create the diverse range of beer styles we enjoy today. Fermentation, then, is where our sugary wort transforms into the alcoholic beverage we love. It's a fascinating process driven by the power of yeast, and it's at the heart of every beer you've ever enjoyed. So the next time you take a sip of your favorite brew, take a moment to appreciate the magic of fermentation. Now we're not quite ready to pop the top yet. There are a few more steps to complete. After fermentation, our beer enters a crucial phase of its journey, the conditioning and maturation. This is the stage where patience truly becomes a virtue. It is during this time that the beer's flavors meld and mature. The yeast, although mostly dormant, continues to metabolize any remaining byproducts from the fermentation stage. This process helps smooth out any harsh flavor edges and allows the beer to develop a more balanced and refined character. You see, every good thing takes time, and beer is no exception. This period of rest is essential for the beer to reach its full potential. The length of maturation varies depending on the type of beer, but it can last from a few days to several months or even years for certain types of specialty beers. As the beer matures, clarification also occurs. Excess yeast and solids settle to the bottom of the fermentation vessel, leaving the beer clear and bright. After a period of conditioning and maturing, the beer is now ready for the final step, packaging. And so our beer embarks on its final phase of the journey. It is packaged in various vessels such as bottles, cans, kegs, or casks, depending on its final destination. But this isn't just about getting the beer into a container. Quality control measures are implemented at this stage to ensure consistency and quality. The beer may go through filtration to remove any remaining solids, and carbonation levels are checked and adjusted to suit the style of the beer. And of course, each container is labeled and branded, ready to be shipped out and enjoyed. So the next time you crack open a cold one, take a moment to appreciate the journey that your beer has made. It's a journey that begins with simple, natural ingredients and ends with a complex, flavorful beverage that has been crafted with care and patience. And that brings us to the end of our beer's journey, from barley to bottle. So let's recall the incredible journey we've just embarked on. We started with the basics, the four natural ingredients that make beer: water, barley, hops, and yeast. We learned how barley goes through malting, a transformative process that readies it for brewing by activating enzymes to convert starches into fermentable sugars. Next, we delved into the art of mashing, where malted barley meets hot water, and the result is a sugary liquid we call wort. The wort is then boiled and hops are introduced, lending their distinctive bitterness, flavor, and aroma. The magic happens during fermentation, where yeast turns sugars into alcohol and carbon dioxide. We discovered the importance of conditioning and maturation, where flavors meld, mature, and attain clarity. Finally, we observed packaging, the final stage where our beer is prepared for its journey to you. And that, my friends, is the remarkable process of how your favorite beer is made.